HTTPS is easy. In part one of this series, I added HTTPS to this site in less than 5 minutes for free. And in part two, I optimized the HTTPS configuration to give us better than bank grade security. Now in part three, what I want to do is fix another couple of problems that have appeared on this site. And this is very typical of what many sites have. Earlier on, I had a green padlock and the secure text up in the top left-hand corner of the browser. That's now gone, and on the top right-hand corner of the browser, I have a little shield with a red cross. Now, what's happening here is I have got content embedded into this page over an insecure connection, which has resulted in the visual indicators I just mentioned. Now, what's actually happened is there's meant to be a video here under part one, another video here under part two, and then I've got this Cloudflare logo embedded on the page. Now, if I hit F12 to go to my development tools and I look at the warning and the errors in the console, we can see that the image was requested insecurely, and there's also two references to YouTube which are insecure as well. Now, we're going to fix this in a couple of different ways. And the first way is to apply a content security policy, which is just one line of HTML. I've actually already pushed it out to this site, so all I'm going to do is push the reload button and we'll have a look at what happens next. So, page reloads, everything looks good again. I've got the padlock and the green secure text and that shield and the red cross is gone from the top right-hand corner. We can now see both my videos embedded properly on the page as well, and the Cloudflare logo's there. And just to be sure, if I press F12 to open up the console, there are no more errors or warnings. So how did I do this? Let's go and have a look at the source code of the page. And you'll see right up towards the top here on line 4, a meta tag, content security policy with the content of upgrade insecure requests. This is all it takes. Just this one line and we've fixed the problem. Now this meta tag means that even if I scroll down to the bottom of the page and notice that both the YouTube videos are still embedded over HTTP, as well as the image embedded over HTTP, upgrade insecure requests still fixes the problem. However, this is not supported by Internet Explorer 11, and support only came to Microsoft Edge in early 2018. Furthermore, the link to my website is still over the insecure connection. So if we're worried about traffic interception, then this could be a problem as well. Let's go and fix all this in one go. I'm going to go back over to Cloudflare, we're on the crypto tab, and I'm going to scroll all the way down to automatic HTTPS rewrites and turn that on. That's now going to force every insecure reference to be secure. So let's go back over to the website, reload it, and then I'm going to view the source again and see if my references have changed. I've still got the meta tag there, which is great, I want to keep that. But if I go down to the bottom, I can see that I've now got an HTTPS link to YouTube, another one to the other YouTube video, and of course one to the image, and one to my blog as well. So what we've now done covers all scenarios. Every single link that can be secure, and Cloudflare does check it first, is now HTTPS, courtesy of the automatic HTTPS rewrites feature, and every other reference, even if it's embedded down in multiple frames or scripts, is also going to be forced to be secure, courtesy of the upgrade insecure requests content security policy meta tag. So that's how you fix insecure references in just a couple of minutes. HTTPS is easy. In the fourth and final video, we're going to look at encrypting everything, all the way back to the server.